Tonight, we're verifying the state of uncertainty for the State of the Union. Today, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi told President Trump the House won't allow next week's speech to move forward after the president turned down her request for a delay. So can she do that? And can the speech still happen? We asked Jeremiah Jacobson to verify.
Well, in her letter to President Trump, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi said the House will not consider a concurrent resolution authorizing the president's State of the Union address. The House's archive confirms the formality, stating both the House and Senate need to approve a resolution for a joint session for a presidential address. So we can verify the president does need an invitation. Now, the State of the Union is a tradition, but the president doesn't need to show up on Capitol Hill to deliver it. Article 2 of the Constitution only says the president shall, from time to time, give to the Congress information of the State of the Union. It doesn't say how, when, or where. The House archives show, after Washington and Adams, the tradition of an annual in-person speech didn't actually pick up again until Woodrow Wilson in 1913. Many have delivered the message in writing, most recently Jimmy Carter in 1981. So it's verified President Trump could still address the State of the Union next week, even without Congress. For Verify, I'm Jeremiah Jacobson.